Ever wonder why the best Madden players are the same every year? Well, today's video is going to explain what are the key principles that are exemplified by all Madden players who are consistently excellent at their craft. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and in today's video, we are diving into the top three things we can learn from every competitive Madden player. And here is the crux and the purpose of this video, real quick from the top. What I want you guys to get out of this is to understand that this kind of tagline or phrase, success leaves trails or tracks or clues, is so critical and so true. So if we look at the players who are the top of the top, and we try to identify a couple commonalities between them, what I hope will happen is it will give you some information that you can then apply to your game in Madden 18 and really narrow down and give you a little bit of a filter to which you can understand the game through these three principal lenses. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to say is a consistent see across all top Madden players is their ability to keep going. And what I mean by their ability to keep going is they never quit. It's a tenacity, it's a mentality, it's an idea, and it's really just a discipline. And the bottom line is, here's what they say, it's one sentence, and each of these are going to be one sentence. The one sentence is, I will never quit no matter how bad it looks. That's it. For some of us, myself included at times, like right here, I want to quit right now because this run right here, for some reason, it's just working and I don't know why. I can't stop it. Like, I want to quit. Madden players who are at the top of their game, who are at the best at what they do, this is what they say: I will not quit regardless. I just won't. It's not a question. It's not even a possibility. Okay? And that's something that most people don't really believe, in my opinion. From everything that I've studied and watched, that is one of the determining factors between someone that is average or okay and really, really good, really, really successful at the game. So, the first one is, I will never quit, no matter how bad it looks, no matter how bad the situation actually is. I will keep fighting, keep playing, because something like that might just happen for me. The second thing that I think is common among all Madden players is they have an intentional scheme. And notice I said the word intentional. So we all, if I asked everybody, do you have a Madden scheme? Most of you would say yes. But here's the thing. If I asked you, does everyone here have a intentional Madden scheme? Most of you would say, what do you mean? And then when I asked you the follow-up question, do you have a reason for every play you run? Most people would say, no, I don't. Okay, a lot of people, this is one of the biggest differences between someone who is a great player and someone who is just an average player. The average player has money plays and they run them and 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 they don't really know why, so then they run a bunch of plays. The above average player, the great player, the player that goes to tournaments, the player that wins money playing this game, they know exactly why they're calling every single play, exactly why they're calling every single play. Okay, the best of the best, the players that make money playing this game, they have a reason for why they call what they call. Okay, so again, here's the statement for that. In every play that I run, there is a reason. In every play that I run, there is a reason. And most players, I would go one step further with that tip. Most players only run two formations. Most players who are top players only run two formations. So that should put into check some of you guys who want to run like 35,000 formations. You should check yourself a little bit at the door because, again, the best Madden players, the people that are making money playing this game, they only run two. Okay? And why do they do that? Well, in my opinion, it's because to be intentional, you have to be focused. And to be focused, you cannot be scattered. Okay? You cannot have 1,000 interests. You need to have one to two. That's why I suggest running two formations only. And the final tip that I have, the final thing that I think distinguishes every successful Madden player who's made money playing this game, who is good every year, the final thing that I want to say, so the first thing we talked about was never quitting. The second thing we talked about was they have an intentional scheme, which means they have a reason for every single play they call. And then the third and final thing is their ability to manage no-win situations. So when I mean no-win situations, here's what I mean. A situation where you pro it's like fourth down and five, and you know you need 5 yards. What they might do is instead of taking a sack where they're going to go back 20 yards, they might actually just throw the ball away or throw it up to be intercepted, or they'll do something to try to intentionally, as I throw a terrible make a terrible read there, they will do something very intentional. Or one thing they'll do is they might, you see this in kickoffs. So in kickoffs, what the great Madden players do is they don't allow kick returns. Like you don't see if you're a top player, you're not going to allow a kickoff return for a touchdown. You're just not. That's just not in the cards. You do everything you can to eliminate that, eliminate big plays. As you see here, I got roasted. Another example of this is a situation where instead of taking a sack, they throw the ball away. Okay. For running purposes, if you're running the ball and you need 2 yards to get a first down, but you think you might be able to break it outside and get 30 yards, they always go for the first down. Okay, so it's little things like that. And the one sentence I will say to that is the difference between a ordinary Madden player and an extraordinary Madden player is the extra. Okay, what is the extra? What is the extra mile for you? It might be mastering your kickoff. It might be using a certain player for a specific purpose. Oftentimes, the best Madden players in the world have everything narrowed down. They know exactly what they're going to do at exactly the time they're going to do it. And what that does, in my opinion, is it takes very critical planning. So it goes back to, even though I am often thought of as someone who believes very little in practice mode, I don't believe in practice mode for the reasons most people believe in practice mode. I believe practice mode is a place to experiment and try new things. But then the next level, the next step to that is to go in a game and figure out exactly what needs to be done in what situations. Bill Belichick talks about this. This is what the Patriots do. They all the time, they're drilling different scenarios, different scenarios, different scenarios, so that when that comes up in the middle of a game, they are prepared and equipped to handle anything. Anything the defense may throw their way, anything that might come up in the game, they're ready for it because they've already practiced in practice. And for Madden, what I would say is that's your, I call them exhibition matches or lab matches. That's why on this tip, one final kind of practical application point for you is all of this. I do not know a successful player in Madden 18 or in any Madden previously that doesn't have at least one to two people of a similar or better skill level that they are practicing with consistently. Practicing with consistently. You're going to have the opportunity this season to get that at length because we're going to be doing a community-wide online franchise, and I'm really excited about it. We're going to get everybody together from the channel, and you're going to be able to get hands-on one-on-one matchups with different players of your skill level. So it's an online franchise, 32 members of my channel. You have to be subscribed to my channel in order to join. And we're just gonna play, and I'm gonna be in it, and there's gonna be other people in it, and we're gonna play, and we're gonna play, and we're gonna play. That is an area of which you're gonna see me. That's where I would go to test things. That's where I'm gonna go to tinker and learn and figure things out. Whereas most people, they just kind of go and play online. That's not enough. The best players, they practice. They have games that are literally set up to go in and practice a specific play against a specific defense. And so, essentially, what I want to leave you with on that one is the best players in the world, they go the extra mile. Okay? They go the extra mile. They do what is necessary to be successful, irregardless of whether or not it's easy, irregardless of whether or not it's comfortable. They go the extra mile. And as you're looking at your game plan for this season, let me just give you three sentences to walk away with. The first thing is, I will never give up no matter what the situation is. I will never quit no matter what the situation is. The third thing is, or the, excuse me, the second thing is, I will have an intentional plan for my actions. I will have an intentional plan for my actions. The reason that's important is because if you don't have a plan, then you're just going to end up somewhere. And ultimately, it's like driving. If you don't have a destination and if you don't have directions, you will get lost and you get abandoned and you will not arrive at your destination. It's the same thing in Madden. Ultimately, our destination is to be the best Madden player we can be. The way we get there is by having a plan, having a systematic approach to the game. What play am I going to call in this situation? What play am I going to call in that situation? Why am I going to call this play versus that play versus this play versus that play? Why? Asking yourself why is going to help you become a better player because you're going to be able to become more intentional in exactly what you do. And then the final thing is they go the extra mile. So I will here's your statements one more time. I will never quit no matter what happens in the game. I will have an intentional scheme slash plan for every action I take. Okay. And then our last one here is I will go the extra mile. I will do whatever it takes to get the job done. I will do whatever it takes to go the extra mile to be the best player I can be. Those three statements are what differentiate the best players in the world from the average players. It's not the scheme, trust me. It's not. It's not the fact that like I'm running pretty much two plays every single time, every single week, every over and over and over again. And as you can see here, we're going to go into overtime. I'm probably going to end up getting the win because I'm just so focused right now. My game's playing really well as I miss the kick and he's going to win, so that's a sucky way to go out. But anyways, guys, that's what the best players do. Those are some of the principles that you can apply to your game to get better. So let me know what you thought of this video. Let me know if it was helpful or not. I want to do more stuff like this where I take lessons that we can learn from the best of the best and distill it down so that you guys can understand and apply them. If you're new to the channel, I want to thank you for joining, and I want to encourage you first and foremost to hit the subscribe button, but second and really more importantly, what I want to encourage you to do is let me know in the comments, how did you find my channel and what can I help you with in Madden 18? How did you find my channel and what can I help you with in Madden 18? I'm looking forward to engaging with you down there, and I'm hoping that our channel can be a resource to help you get better in Madden 18. Thanks.